स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं
Yes.
Suffer.
No, the first statement is wrong.
But in the family, all we are suffering.
Yes. Sorry?
When we are there in the family, with the same wife, with the same life. So, what is my question that, does it mean that if you are suffering intensely, you are progressing on your path towards God?
Two things. The statement which I made, the same wife, same life, same car, just a jovial statement. But to tell you honestly, neither your wife, nor your car, or your house is same as yesterday's. It is different. You can't step into the same river twice. I tell you, you can't even step into the same river even once. See, the moment you put your foot, before even it reaches the ground, water moves away. So, your wife is updating herself. Your life is updating itself. The whole existence is constantly updating itself. So my statement, the same wife, same car, same thing, was told in a more casual sense and a jovial sense and how you feel. But that is not the case. Actual truth. That's the first thing. Second thing, if we are suffering, are we growing towards God? No. Something seriously wrong. I can say, in the initial level, you will not have suffering, you will have suffocation. Suffocation is what Ramakrishna calls the seeking or the intense yearning. Vyakulata, that is the word Bhagavan uses, Ramakrishna is using. Vyakulata, the intense yearning. There will be suffocation, not suffering. Suffocation means feeling that you are not enough. You have not expanded what you can. You are not doing what you can. It's just like missing some part of you. It won't be a suffering. Suffering is different. Suffocation is different. Suffering is something when you think I need this and you are not achieving. That is suffering. Suffocation is you know you are something but you have not become that. Suffocation is from within, suffering from outside. Suffocation is from prarabdha, suffering is from agamya. Prarabdha means the potentiality which you brought with you is prarabdha. Agamya is the desires which you accumulated after coming here. The accumulated desires bring suffering, the agamya brings suffocation. Suffocation inspires and helps you to expand, open up, break. Suffering puts you in deep depression. So I feel suffocation will just explode into joy. There won't be suffering between you and the enlightenment or the Atmanyana. So I can't accept the word if you are suffering more, you are going towards divine, towards God. According to my experience, not only goal, even the path is anandamaya. Path and goal, both are anandamaya. In the initial level, the suffocation will be there. Please understand the difference between the suffocation and suffering. Suffering is from the accumulated desires. Suffocation is from your inborn, prarabdha, tendency, the potential energy. So when a seed has not become tree, when the seed is about to break, it has that suffocation, vyakulata. But suffering is after you become tree. Suddenly you want maybe 2-3 house built on you or 2-3 cars so that you can get into that. Tree can't move. Which you try to accumulate something which is not directly yours, your very quality. That is what I call suffering. Suffering is from akamya. Suffocation is from prarabdha. Prarabdha, suffocation may be there in the initial level in your spiritual path, but agamya, the suffering, a depression cannot be there in your spiritual journey, then there's something wrong if the suffering is there. First sit and clear the suffering. That's a basic need to start your journey. Thank you. Yes. I'll answer 10 more minutes. Yes.
How do you attain contentment?
Sit and contemplate. Make a list of all your desires. All your desires, whatever, even the small to big, even the fulfilled desires. If you remember, it means it is there in you. List. List and sit and contemplate. Just take up each desire and visualize that it has become reality. How you feel. Add Kriya Shakti to Icha Shakti. Add your visualization and creativity to your desires. Suddenly you will see many desires which you thought is your life will drop, will lose its influence over you. Empower your visualization, your desires with your imagination power. Just see that they have become reality and how you feel now. Suddenly you will see many desires which you thought is an important thing in your life will lose its power over you. Those desires are your agamya, accumulated desires. And suddenly you will see some desires will become so strong in you. That's what I call prarabdha, your own desires. With prarabdha, you see prarabdha, great quality of the prarabdha karma is, before fulfilling, it will give you a deep inspiration and energy to run behind the desire. After fulfilling, automatically that will give you a deep satisfaction. But with agamya, before fulfilling also you will have a deep irritation. Sometime you will see, if you remember some desires, you will have a deep irritation. After fulfilling, you will feel the deep emptiness. Agamya will start with irritation and end with emptiness. Prarabdha will start with inspiration, end with fulfillment. So sit and contemplate on all the desires. Take this as a meditation. Every day visualize one desire fully. Create your heaven and live half an hour in that. It may look like imagination. What am I doing? But you will see suddenly there are many desires which you are carrying without even knowing that they have no say over your being. They have no power over your being. When the agamya drops, prarabdha will have its own energy to fulfill itself. Thank you.
Shivoham, Shivoham, Shivoham.